drugs up and send you back to Barnhurst
with
them.
Would you keep your voice down?
Why? Everybody knows you're selling drugs. The whole prison does.
Shut up! The bloody screws don't. I don't want another word out of you. I'm going to be top dog of this crap heap. Screw Judy and Myra. The women will stick with me because I can supply what they want. And no one's going to get in my way.
What's happened?
She's mad! She's bloody mad! She just poured water over her bottle!
Water! Here, I'm standing over there.
Why
do you want to Phyllis and Myra away from her? Gloria, tell them, for God's sake!
Hey, Desmond, you're on a charge for an unwarranted and sadistic attack on a fellow prisoner.
Oh, Pixie, we're supposed to be on a go slow.
Oh, gosh, yes, that's right. It's hard to remember to go slow all the time, isn't it?
You reckon? Have a look at this lot. They're loving it.
I'm glad they took Margo and Rev away. It's much nicer without them.
Where the hell's Doreen? She said she was coming right back from the kitchen.
You're still worrying about Myra, aren't you? Honestly, she's far too sensible to do anything silly.
Well, I hope you are going to be sensible too and not do anything stupid like look around in Margot's cell.
I promised you I wouldn't. Now stop worrying about me.
Can't help worrying about you. You're the sort of person people like to worry about.
The sort of person people like to worry about. Oh, that's nice. It's like an old saying, like, being in love means never having to say you're sorry. Never did understand what that meant.
Hey, guess what? I've heard there's been an accident in the kitchen. Gloria's been hurt and Myra's been marched off to the pound.
What happened?
Well, I couldn't find out exactly. All I know is that Myra's in real big trouble.
You're right after all.
Well, I knew it this morning at muster, didn't I? When the freaks sent Gloria and Myra off to kitchen duty. I suppose Phyllis was still there.
Yeah, do you reckon she had something to do with it?
Well, what do you think?
Well, you never know. Perhaps she did lose her temper and do something silly.
Yeah, she could have got pushed into it.
She wouldn't have done it. She promised because of her kids. It had to be a setup.
Mason, Gloria's here to see you.
Mr. Manning, how's Myra?
I don't know anything about it. This case slow is a waste of time, you know that.
Not to us, it's not. The department will have to do something eventually.
Gosh, I hope my lawyer's nice.
Good old Pix never gives up trying, eh? Well, come on, Jude. Don't be worried. Gloria deserves everything she gets.
Yeah, she probably does, but Myra doesn't. Not with her trial coming up in a minute.
Oh, Officer O'Shea, I'll take her in. The governor's just finishing a call.
Does she believe Myra did it?
Relax. Everything's playing into our hands. The governor has just been informed that Payne has been called as a witness against Desmond at her trial.
Yeah? Well, that'd give her all the more reason to do it anyway. I'm surprised she didn't do it.
Well, just make sure you add that to the story when you tell the governor your version of what happened.
Geez, what if they find out the truth?
Look, I've already told the governor what I saw, and so has Officer Radcliffe. There was Payne, scalded and writhing in agony, and Desmond standing over. You were just another witness.
Miss Ferguson, show her in, please.
Okay. Now, don't overplay your hand. Everything is going our way.
I just can't get over it, Mr. Hamlin. You seem awfully young to be a lawyer.
No, not really. Legal aid lawyers are usually about my age. Look, if you'd rather have someone else.
Oh, no, I didn't mean that. I just meant that, well, you must be awfully clever to be so important so quickly.
Well, I don't know about being important, Miss Mason. And as for clever, we'll have to see how I go at your trial tomorrow.
I suppose we should get it over and done with it. I just wish it wasn't so soon.
Yes, I must admit that I'd like to have had more time in trying to trace Ralph Cranton.
You can't find him?
No. No sign of him at the flat where you stayed, and he didn't leave any forwarding address. I contacted his parents, but they hadn't heard from him in over 3 months.
Oh, well, never mind. I'll just have to explain to the judge and show him the card Ralph wrote me.
Look, I'm afraid it's not quite as simple as that. For one thing, the prosecution will undoubtedly claim that you wrote the card yourself.
Oh, but I didn't. Well, why would I want to do that? Because then I'd know that Mrs. Powell didn't write it, wouldn't I? I'm not that silly.
No. Look, I'll call in a handwriting expert to testify that it wasn't your writing.
Well, there you are, then.
That's not all there is to it, I'm afraid.
I have complete confidence in you, Mr. Hamlin. I know you'll make them believe that I didn't mean to escape and convince them not to give me a longer sentence, won't you?
Well, I'll certainly try.
Well, I heard Myra say something about Gloria not being able to talk now. Well, I didn't know what she meant, and the next thing I knew it had happened.
You actually saw Desmond tip the boiling water over her?
Oh, yeah. I couldn't believe me eyes. I mean, I knew Myra had it in for her, but I didn't think she'd do nothing like that.
No.
Of course, Myra's been saying ever since Gloria came in that she was going to fix her, but
yes, Hunt, I'm sure the governor has the picture.
Thank you for being so open with me, Hunt. You women are usually so strict about your no-lagging rule.
Yeah, well, I thought...
Well, Governor, I did take the liberty of explaining to Hunt before we came in that this was far too serious a matter to be playing those sort of games.
Yeah, and I can't afford no more trouble, not after that business with the kid. I thought it was better if I told the truth.
Yes, well, I'm glad you did.
Oh, sorry, I can come back later.
Come in, Mrs. Powell. That'll be all, Hunt. Miss Ferguson?
How does it look?
Oh, bad for Myra. Apparently she knew Payne would be a witness at the trial.
Yeah, well, it's logical, isn't it? And she's got the brain. She still has the women under control. They're going slow, even without her.
Unfortunately, the department thinks if we ignore the strike, it'll go away.
Well, they could be right. If the women see they're getting nowhere, they'll soon get sick of it.
Well, off the record, I hope they don't. I know Erica Davidson disagrees with me. She thinks I'm mishandling the whole situation.
Oh, I don't know about that. She's usually pretty understanding.
Oh, I wouldn't bet on it. She tore strips off me for not moving Payne the minute I knew she was going to be a witness. I tried to explain about the overcrowding and everything, but all she said was I'd left it a little late. Talk about stating the obvious.
Well, at least they can't blame you about Stevens and Mitchell.
Thank God for that.
Have you heard anything?
No. You know, that escape was planned very carefully. Young Mitchell couldn't possibly have had anything to do with it. She didn't have time. So what if she got in the way?
Mm. Oh, yes, Stevens. She's a survivor. But I don't know about Mitchell.
Well, well, well. Very nice. Looks a lot better than that blue dress you've been wearing.
Let's say that's what I'm used to.
Huh. On Eddie's wage? You must be joking. Why would a classy Sheila like you waste all that time on a cop and a suburban marriage?
Well, it was a good cover, I mean. Who'd suspect a policeman's wife of running a prostitution racket?
Very clever. Just don't try to be too clever with me.
Why should I when you're calling the shots? I'm quite happy.
Good.
Why don't I go and get the other things that I bought today?
Just don't forget you're going to have to earn all these things.
Then I'll make sure the girls keep hard at it.
That's just a sideline and you know it. Your real value is being bait for your husband.
Oh? I thought it was to stop him giving evidence.
That's what he's been told. Your life for his silence. But he won't stop at that. When he finds out where you are, he'll come after you. And I'm going to make sure he finds out where you are. You, my dear, are the worm on the hook.
It's important you get Eddie, isn't it?
Lionel doesn't like being double-crossed. And I wasn't born with a bad leg. Eddie put a bullet in it a couple of years ago. I owe him for that. I'm going to kill him personally. In the meantime, his wife's going to be very, very nice to me. It's an interesting twist, don't you think? We'll be spending quite a bit of time together, and I expect you to do your best to give satisfaction.
I've never had any complaints. It'll be a pleasure for both of us.
I can see what Eddie saw in you. You're beautiful and intelligent. I think we'll get along real well.
Oh, I know that. Really well.
Well, I thought it was Gino I had to pay up to.
Either me or Gino. We're brothers. And partners. We share everything.
Sick, that guy.
Look, he just likes things a little bit different. So do I. You'll find out. Look, a lot of people around here like things a little bit unusual. You just remember, you give them exactly what they want.
Told you before, I'm not into them sort of things.
You are now. You want to go on breathing? All right. This is the way you'll be working. Done it before, so you know what to do.
I only did it because I had to. I used to choose it.
You don't knock anybody back. And don't just stand here. Some of them need encouragement. You give them your biggest smile. You speak to them. You get them interested. Keeping an eye on you. All right, start earning your keep.
There you go.
Things just seem to keep happening, don't they?
Yeah, don't they? Maybe with some help.
What do you mean?
Well, what do you reckon? The minute you ask for new machines, the old ones start to develop a whole lot of fault. It's very convenient.
We wouldn't do anything to them, honestly, we wouldn't.
Oh, no, no, of course not. We won't forget to let me know if something else goes wrong.
No worries, Mr. Manning.
He's a bit cranky today, isn't he? He's usually so charming.
Oh, he's a screw, isn't he? If a screw comes to work in a bad mood, then he'd take it out on us.
Oh, he's just a bit depressed because he's lonely, Judy. He just needs a romantic interest.
Yeah, that's what Bobbie thought. I wonder how she's getting on.
Hey, I got the news on Myra. You want to hear it?
Yeah, what happened?
Well, Gloria got burnt with boiling water and she's in a pretty bad way.
It must have been Phyllis.
Well, they reckon it was Myra.
No way. Myra wouldn't do it and I believe her. I've got to talk to the governor.
Well, what can you do?
I don't know, but I've got to do something.
Fix your face for you, kid. You've got a choice.
What's going on?
This bitch is on my territory.
I showed you where your spot is.
Yeah, well, I didn't know I couldn't move.
Get back there.
You got a lot to learn, honey. Yeah, I did make a mistake. Thought you were lining up for your pension check.
I'm not saying that Myra did it, Jude, but she made no secret of how she felt about Gloria, and that's going to look bad for her.
Yeah, maybe. Did you see how nervous Phyllis was? She couldn't even look us in the eye.
Yeah, I know, but she's got the freak on her side. And what are you going to do about that?
What I said I was going to do. I'm going to go and see the governor, and I'm going to go and do it now.
Not off with Myra's trial coming up, isn't it?
Yeah, I reckon I'll throw the book at her.
Well, my lawyer's a lovely man. He should be able to get me off.
You never know, Pix. Of course, it depends on the judge. He might fancy you.
Oh, Doreen, don't be awful. I bet you've had a lot of romances in your time.
Had to beat him off with a huge stick.
Well, we're both experienced. We should be able to help Mr. Manning, shouldn't we?
What are you talking about?
Well, I'm making up a list of eligible ladies for him.
Oh, well, I reckon he likes the pink, sort of airy, fairy, womanly type.
Hmm, so do I. Well, so far it's only a short list. Mrs. Reynolds or Mrs. Morris?
Hmm, that's what I call short, all right.
Well, can you think of anyone else?
Well, I'm getting out of here soon. Maybe you could fix him up with me.
Hey, I hadn't thought of that. Do you want me to add you
Pixie,
to my list?
Pixie, it was a joke. Me and Screws are natural enemies, you know?
Well, what do you think? Mrs. Reynolds or Mrs. Morris?
Why don't we give him both, you know, keep his hands full?
Oh, Doreen, I'm being serious.
Sorry, Pix. What about the freak?
Also, Bryant's outside. She wants to see you. Have you got the time?
Oh, yes, bring her in. It's probably about Myra, is it?
Yes, I think it is. Listen, could I get off a little earlier today? I've got an appointment with an estate agent.
Yes, of course. You definitely decided to sell.
Yeah. About 4 o'clock?
Mm, sure.
Okay. Come on, Brian.
Thank you.
I'll wait outside.
Yes, Judy.
I want to talk to you about Myra.
Yes, I thought it might be about that.
Yeah.
Look, there's no way she could have done that, not with a trial coming up.
Judy, you don't know the facts.
She cared too much about her kids. She would have never done it, not deliberately anyway.
I'm sorry you don't know the facts. There were witnesses.
Oh, Ferguson and Phyllis.
And Miss Radcliffe. Be sensible, Judy. You know why they don't like each other. I should have separated them earlier, but it was difficult to arrange, and Myra had given me her word there'd be no more trouble.
Yeah, she gave me her word too, and she meant it.
Well, there has been more trouble, and Myra was in the middle of it.
But she didn't do it.
I can't ignore the evidence, Judy. She must have been provoked. And unfortunately, you're right. It will go against her at the trial. But she should have thought of that at the time.
But it's not true.
Can you prove that?
Of course not.
Okay, Mario, keep in touch.
You pour a mean drink, among other things. I must take more afternoons off.
Yeah, I enjoyed it too. But it would be much better with the phone off the hook.
I can't. I'm a businessman. Mario seems to think you've got a good eye for talent. All the girls you picked for the flats have started earning money already.
Good.
Can't say the same for your little friend. She's only managed to turn two tricks so far.
Well, she's probably trying to acclimatise herself to the new territory.
Crap, she's a waste of space.
Well, I'd have put somebody else on the beat.
You mean it wouldn't worry you if we had to get rid of Mitchell?
If she can't do the job properly, then she has to go.
Let me tell you something, Mrs. Stevens. You are my kind of lady.
You very nearly said too much in there, Hunt. The governor's no fool.
I was scared and you said...
All right, all right. I don't think there was any harm done.
What about when Gloria tells them it was me?
She won't have to. While we're waiting for the sister, I... mentioned that I'd seen the whole thing. By the time she's ready for questioning, she'll be convinced it was Desmond.
I hope she is.
Oh, take it easy. You've got no worries. I'm behind you, aren't I?
Yeah.
It just leaves Kean. And I haven't forgotten about her either. You'll have to wait till I get back.
Get back? Where are you going?
Just taking a few days off.
The women will kill me.
Oh, don't be stupid. They're not going to do anything that's going to cause more trouble for Desmond. You just take things quietly till I get back.
Well, I don't think I'll be able to do anything to Kean with you away.
You won't have to. Just keep an eye on her and find out where her weak spots are.
Well, I reckon she'd like to get her hand on Gaffney's dope supply.
Drugs? Well, how did they get in?
I don't know. Look, all I'm saying is when you get back, you might be able to get Gaffney and Kean at the same time. Well, I'll keep tabs on them for you if you like.
Yeah, you do that, Hunt. Just remember, it's me keeping you out of the black hole. So don't get smart while I'm gone. Just remember, I want all bets fully accounted for.
Yeah, you'll get your share.
I'd better. And Hunt, remember, you're just another animal in this zoo. It pays to stay in with the keeper.
You would have finished your shift by now.
No, not yet, Pixie. I'll be leaving shortly, though.
Oh, gosh, you're lucky. I bet you're going somewhere really nice tonight, aren't you?
Yeah, well, I haven't had a home-cooked meal for a while, and a friend's invited me out for dinner.
Oh, lovely. A lady friend?
Oh, yeah. Mrs. Morris is going to be cooking.
Oh, yes. Oh, that's lovely. You're both such sensitive, understanding people.
Tell Mrs. Morris you said so.
Oh, she's definitely the type who needs a husband. I hope you have a lovely dinner. Well, I've just got to go and tell somebody.
Hi, how are you?
Fine.
Got a bit of time to spare, have you?
Yeah.
$30 and you walk away smiling.
All right.
Not here. You let people throw money into a hat. Jeez, come on.
Look, if you're prepared to wait just a little while, you could probably get a better price for it.
I'd rather sell now.
And you definitely want to sell it furnished?
Yes, I do.
Well, sometimes that makes it a lot harder. Look, why don't you sell them off separately?
I would rather do it all at once. I'll take any personal possessions, of course, but I want everything else to go.
I see.
My husband and children were killed recently.
I'm sorry. We'll do our very best to sell it as quickly as possible.
Thank you.
Oh, well, you'll come back all tanned and looking relaxed.
I doubt it, under the circumstances.
No?
Yeah, my father's been referred to a specialist in Sydney. I'm going to go with him.
I'm sorry, I didn't realise. Well, this is a follow-up to the strike, is it?
It's a follow-up to whatever Kean and those thugs did to him during the escape.
Oh, nasty business. How old is he again?
At age, he's got nothing to do with it. He's a very fit man.
Oh, that's good. So what does the doctor have to say?
The doctor? The very reason we've got to go to Sydney is his inability to diagnose the problem.
It's Ferguson. I just wanted to say goodbye before I left. I hope everything goes well for your father.
Yeah, me too. I'll see you when you get back.
Yeah, thanks.
All right, Governor.
Night, Rick. I might have a look at the rosters. Meg had to make some changes.
Look, I'm sorry to be taking leave when we seem to be having so many problems around here.
Don't be silly. Family comes first. Anyway, Colleen feels that she can handle full-time work again.
Huh? Is she returning as deputy governor?
No, Meg will continue as deputy governor for the moment. Colleen's still under a lot of strain and I want to make sure she has an easy workload.
Yes, of course. I hope the department hasn't regretted rescinding my resignation.
No, of course not. Why?
Well, there doesn't seem to be much communication from them, except what you tell me. It's almost as if they're giving me the cold shoulder.
I'm afraid it'll be some time before they forget that you were prepared to help a prisoner escape.
They must have realised why.
You wouldn't be back here if they hadn't. But you know the department. Cold, hard facts on official reports never look good.
So now I'm a security risk, eh? That's marvellous, isn't it? All those years of hard work and now I've got to prove myself all over again.
Yes, well, are you flying off tonight?
No, I don't finish till late. I'll catch a plane in the morning.
Well, you should have spoken to Meg. She could have changed the roster.
It doesn't matter. A few things I have to do before I go. Well, I'll say goodbye and see you when I get back.
Yes, goodbye. And look after your father.
Thanks.
G'day.
Hello.
I got a bit of a surprise when Gino set out to meet you. What's going on?
They're worried about your attitude and I said I'd try and straighten you out. If I can't, then they'll let Gino have you. You know what that means. You'll just disappear.
What have I been doing wrong?
Apparently you have been uncooperative.
Uncooperative? What the bloody hell did
I
expect?
Keep your voice down. The little watchdog over there is just as likely to repeat every word you say to Winner.
I've had to deal with some real creeps, and Gino's one of them. I'm not kidding. The things that guy makes me do are sick.
It's all part of the job.
It's all right for you, isn't it?
Oh, listen, you're not the only one who has to grin and bear it. I've got to put up with Grinner pouring me, and he turns my stomach.
Yeah, well, I don't know how much longer I can put up with it. I have to shoot through.
With people like that, you don't just shoot through. Gino seems to think you're not worth the trouble.
He's a bastard.
Look, I have stuck my neck out for you a couple of times and I'm not going to do it anymore. One more bad report from you and I might just have to say to Renner, I think that he should get rid of you. Permanently.
Well, well. You will have to learn to control that temper of yours, Gaffney.
I never done this.
Really? Who did then?
Beats me.
Oh. Must have been someone with a grudge against you. Or perhaps it was just someone wanting to steal something. That is, of course, a theory, isn't it?
I've got nothing worth stealing, Miss Ferguson.
Well, I'd say the person who did this doesn't believe you. And you know what, Gaffney? I think they'll try again.
But that'd be a waste of time, Miss Ferguson. Like I said, I've got nothing
worth
stealing.
You know, Gaffney, there is one truth in Wentworth. And that is you can't keep your little treasures hidden forever. It's only a matter of time. I get this mess cleaned up before I put you on a charge.
Right, Miss Ferguson.
Here's to a night off. And your release from isolation.
Shouldn't you be slaving over a hot stove?
No. Casserole's in the oven, and the dessert is straight out of the supermarket deep freeze. Sit down.
You're very organised, aren't you?
Well, I'm not really. I mean, we were supposed to be having soup tonight, but I just forgot all about it. Don't know what's happening to me lately.
Well, you're a lot more domesticated than I am. When you're on the force, you learn to live out of hamburger bars and things.
Oh, well, I enjoy cooking. It's not so much fun on your own. That's why it's been rather nice having Colleen here.
Yeah, isn't she meant to be here tonight?
Oh, maybe later. She's out with a neighbour and then couldn't get out of a dinner invitation. Stop worrying, Rick. She doesn't blame you for what happened.
Yeah, all the same, I'd feel a lot better if I could help in some way.
Well, I think she's over the worst of the shock now. And even if she does sell the house, I hope she doesn't try living on her own too quickly.
Do you ever spend any time to worry about yourself?
Of course I do. But you know what it's like living on your own. You get used to it.
Yeah.
Anyway, how could you ask anyone to share the life that we lead with our sort of job?
Well, if I ever find a lady to take Celia's place, this job is going to run a very poor second.
Mr. Manning, I wish you happy hunting.
Hi. Sorry I'm late. I got held up at the public trustee office.
Late? I didn't think you were going to get home till after 10. I thought you were with a neighbour.
No, that was put off till next week. I told you this afternoon, remember?
Yes.
Hoping there was some cold water. Isn't there enough? I can always get takeaway.
Well, there's plenty. You could make yourself useful and set the table.
All right, done.
You want a hand?
No. Sit there and relax.
Come on, Jude, how about a song? I heard that you do Louis Armstrong real good. Or what about Kenny Rogers?
Oh, no, the Deltones.
Oh, yeah, we'll take a vote. Hey, Margo, what do you want, Kenny Rogers or the Deltones?
Well, I want the bitch who turned my cell over.
Don't you start throwing your muscle around here, Gaffney. You might bite off more than you can chew.
Desmond may be in the pound, but I know she ordered it.
Well, before you start pointing your finger around in here, why don't you look to your own mates? I bet they'd do anything to get their hands on that dope.
Yeah, what about Reb or Weasel?
As a matter of fact, you might as well just give it to them. Because when Myra gets out of the pound, you are going to be out of business.
Don't count on it. The women want a top dog who'll give them what they want. Then you'll be the one sweating, Bryant.
We'll stick with Myra, Jude.
Yeah, I reckon most people will. She'll look after us.
Yeah, I hope so. But she's got to face a charge over Gloria. And then she has a murder trial. Now, how much can she take?
Yes. Excuse me, I don't know how you got past the monkey downstairs, but I can always call him and have you removed.
I'm Libby Blake.
So you're Libby. Looking for a job.
You're on my turf.
Look, Kurt's going to be home very soon. I suggest you leave now.
I came to see Kurt. He didn't come to waste time with his latest little tart.
It's funny being a has-been. You always have to be told twice.
You listen to me, you little bitch.
Temper, Libby. What is it today? Haven't you had your fix? Oh, yes, Kurt told me all about your expensive little habit. He told me he was sick of it and sick of you. I'm sorry, Libby. You're out. I'm in. Well, now that you've finished your drink, I suggest you leave.
I've still got heavy friends, Stevens. Let's see how long Kurt keeps you around after they've done a face job on you.
Comfortable, Desmond?
I don't have to talk to you.
Oh, I just thought you'd like to know I'll be gone for a few days. That ought to cheer you up. But I won't miss you too much, Desmond, because you'll be here when I get back. Yeah, you'll be convicted of murder. Payne's evidence will see to that. No, I don't expect you to enjoy your trial too much, but I certainly will. Yeah, I'll get a blow-by-blow description from the newspapers. Are you listening to me? You know the only thing I regret? I won't be in the courtroom to see your loving daughter get up in that witness box and put you away for life. Oh, I'd really like to see that. But I expect you can tell me all about it when I get back. Have fun, Desmond.
Must have been awfully romantic.
Oh, yeah.
Did you and Mr. Manning have a nice time last night? I mean, a nice dinner?
Yes, thank you.
Mr. Manning told me he was invited. He's a lovely man, isn't he?
Oh, very nice fellow, Mrs. Morris. I think he's a good catch for the right girl, that is.
Oh, yes, you'd have to be the right girl. Well, somebody who understood how hard his job was and could share it with him. Well, don't you think so, Mrs. Morris?
I think if you don't hurry, you could end up with cold showers. And I'm not sure that wouldn't be a bad thing.
Oh, I knew there was something I forgot. Do you mind if I go and get my shower back?
Oh, Pixie, please, make it snappy.
You still dealing?
Maybe.
What do you mean, maybe?
Got the cash? You got any stuff, haven't you?
Sure you didn't try and help yourself last night?
Of course not. Told you, I'm on your side.
Yeah, like a rash.
Representatives have indicated they are hopeful that a compromise can be found. Government sources indicate there will be no backdown over the dispute. In Victoria yesterday, police reported there had been no sighting of the two female escapees from Wentworth Detention Centre. Police are now convinced that Sonia Stevens and Roberta Mitchell were abducted while on routine transfer to another prison. It's believed they may be the victims of underworld vengeance, and great fears are held for their safety. The state opposition have called for a royal commission into the incident. And now, sporting news.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Pixie, I told you to hurry up.
I'm going as fast as I can, honestly, I am.
No, go and get the others. Oh, put a sock in it, Parker, as if it isn't bad enough. You know your trouble, Keith. You're so busy having a bad time, you wouldn't know a good time to hit you between the eyeballs. How you going, Pix?
Oh, really well, thanks, sir. Only, I couldn't find my things. Oh, I'm sorry I dropped your talcum powder, Margo, but I didn't spill very much.
You what?
Oh, don't worry about it, because I picked most of it up. But really, if it smells as bad as that, you should be thankful. Your soap smells absolutely beautiful.
You've been at my things, you bitch!
But I didn't steal anything. I'll pay you back a fire, honestly.
You don't touch another person's things. Or have the rules changed since I was last here?
Yeah, the rules haven't changed. She just forgot, that's all.
She's only a lousy cake of soap.
That's not the point, is it?
I didn't mean to do anything wrong, Judy.
Yeah, I know that, love, but please, don't let it happen again, okay?
I don't know why everybody's so upset. The water's so nice today, isn't it?
Yeah, sing along, Pix. Ma'am.
See, Bib loves me. Try something, Doreen. Bib loves to have got it made.
I've had enough. A tin dunny fell on a brick by brick.
I've got some news you might be interested in.
As long as it's good.
Well, it depends on your point of view, of course. There's a new rumour sweeping the prison.
Oh, who's the victim this time?
Us. Now, according to Pixie, I lured you to my house last night because you are a good catch.
Yeah, well, you see, Pixie feels that I need a good woman, you know, to keep me from my loneliness.
Well, Cass is backing her up.
Well, they'll have the confetti cut as we speak.
Seriously, though, I do think we ought to put an end to it.
Toss you for the honour.
Right. Heads. You tell Pixie.
I'm sorry to have to question you like this, Payne, but you must realise how serious the charge is.
It hurts. It bloody hurts.
Look, if the pain is too much, I could come back later.
No. Till now, get over with.
All right, well, I just want you to tell me exactly what happened.
Well, I was standing next to the stove. Desmond was next to me. I bent down to pick something up, and that's when I caught the water.
And you're sure Myra was responsible?
Of course I'm bloody certain.
Hunt was in the kitchen. Where was she?
How should I know? You on Desmond's side or something?
No, I just want to hear the truth, so please answer the questions. Now, were you aware of Miss Ferguson entering the kitchen?
Yeah. She came in just as it happened. She'll pat me up.
And you're sure that the entire thing wasn't just an accident?
Listen, her daughter thinks more of me than she does of her. I shacked up with her old man. So what do you reckon?
Well, I reckon you could be in a lot of trouble if you're not telling the truth.
I am one of the main witnesses at that bitch's trial. She reckons she could stop me being there. You think I'm lying, don't you, Mrs. Bell?
No, I didn't say that. I've spoken to the doctor. He thinks it would be best if you were transferred to Wentworth General, so you'll be going
as
soon
as... Did he say if I could make the trial?
He's advised against it. However, the police have agreed to accept your evidence on videotape under the circumstances.
They won't need any bloody tape recorder. I'll be there in court. I want to see the look on her face when she gets life. I want to see it.
For crying out loud, cool up, you Pixie.
But it's important to me, Doreen. I have to know. Do you think you'd look good in a morning suit?
Oh, Stu, will you talk to her? She's hopeless. She's going to get copped in a minute.
What's wrong, Ma?
Oh, nothing. I'm just having a lovely time, that's all.
Oh. You late, Kean? Yeah, had a few things to do.
Have you told Pixie yet?
No, right, I'll do that now, yeah.
Good morning, Mr. Manning. Have you had breakfast? It's very nice this morning. I'm going to get some more.
Yeah, well, hang on. I want to have a word with you.
Oh, she's going to get sprung for sure.
Oh, come on. I think she's just sillier than usual this morning.
Judy, she's out of her tree. Margo must have given her something.
And I do. I appreciate your concern for me, but the matchmaking has got to stop as of right now. You get it?
Anything you say, Mr. Manning.
Now, you understand what I'm saying to you?
If being miserable and alone makes you happy, well, then that's wonderful. At least you're happy, and that's the most important thing, isn't it? Home again, jiggity-jig.
What did I tell you?
What's going on?
Now, look, who's done this to you, Pix? Hmm? Come on, you can tell us where you're mates.
Of course you are, but I'm having a wonderful time. What's wrong with that?
Pixie, have you been into Margot's stuff?
Oh, Judy, I wouldn't do anything like that. Oh, heavens, what is wrong with everybody today? Looks like I have to cheer you all up.
She should be coming out of it by now. Gee, she was lucky.
Yeah, more ways than one. I'd love to know who got her fired up like that.
Could be Margo. She was real mad at Pix this morning. Could be her way of getting back.
I don't think so. I don't think Margo would ever give away something for nothing. She might give Pixie a black eye, but she'd never give her any free dope. Mm. Well, welcome back to the land of the living, more or less.
How you going, Margo?
What do you reckon, Cass?
Well, the press is all yours. Only problem is the press isn't working. It's been a slight technical hitch.
We kept the go slow up for you, though, Myra.
It's okay, Mrs. Morris. I know how you feel about
it. If you knew that, you'd all be back at work. Now, I'm sorry, ladies, but the department will not be pressured like this.
All right, is anything else breaking down? Because when this bloke comes to fix this press, I hope he finds out what's wrong with it is due to natural causes.
What about an act of God, Mr. Manning?
She was in jail.
Pixie, you better go and change. You'll be taken to court in about an hour.
Oh, gosh, I knew something would ruin today. I haven't got anything to wear.
No, it's all right, Pixie. You just tell the truth.
Yeah. Well, second. Better still, why don't you keep your mouth shut, let the legal eagle do the talking.
But what if they find out about Ralph?
Pixie, I haven't got all day.
Good luck,
Pixie. Jeez, Mr. Manning, you reckon she'll be okay?
Pixie, give her 2 minutes in the witness stand. They won't know what struck them. There'll be judges banging gavels and they'll be tearing their wigs out. They won't know what's happening.
It's all right for him making jokes, but they could throw the book at her. What if they tweak she's on dope?
Oh, I don't know. The screws never picked it.
Yeah, but they know what she's supposed to be like. What about people who don't know her? Suppose they spot it in court.
Well, let's be realistic. The last time she was in court, she fooled about three judges, and then she was straight.
Mm. Well, poor old Myra. Someone did a job on you, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, the freak set me up. With the help of the weasel. No point in going to trial now. I'll throw away the key and call today.
Yeah, we thought it was that much. Listen, Myra. Margo's going to try and make a bid for top dog.
Oh, Jude, you think I give a damn about that now?
Well, you have to. Now, if you don't, this place is going to be run with dope. The women don't want that. They're counting on you. You've got to give a damn.
What do you reckon?
There is no way I can hold top dog against Margo. Too many people like Reb and Phyllis willing to back her up. Yeah, and they might even still do it, even if she does change her mind.
Yeah, well, like you said, she's been through a lot.
Yeah, well, who hasn't? Look, someone has to take over, and at the moment, the only person that can do it is Myra. Now, if she drops her bundle, we're all going to have to pay for it.
The dope's gone! This creep took it, but I know who ordered it.
When you find out, I'll give him a medal.
Listen, I want this settled now!
You bitch! No, let him do it! You want it settled, Margo? You've got it!
To give me roses, I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.